Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let me show you how you can create a narrated video slideshow using only Keynote. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 500 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you could read more about it, join us, and get exclusive content. So a very simple way to create an information video is to use Keynote. Keynote can be used, of course, to do presentations. You can make slides and present them in front of an audience. But you can also record yourself giving that presentation, recording your voice on the microphone and the timing as you advance from slide to slide. Then you can export that as video. And then you can share that video a number of ways, including uploading it to YouTube. It's a great way to get information out there in video format. So here I have a simple 11 slide Keynote presentation. So I have a title slide here and then an interesting piece of information on all of the additional slides. So the idea is I want to export this as a video with voice narration and music. Now I could go to File, Export to Movie, and then say do a self-playing export, give a number of seconds for each slide, a resolution, and export it. And then I would just end up with video with no audio or anything like that. I can bring that into iMovie and I can record narration over it. But you can do all of that right here in Keynote. The first thing you need to do though is record the presentation. So this is like giving the presentation in front of an audience, except there's nobody there but you and your microphone. And you talk through the presentation and advance the slides at the precise times you want to advance them. It's going to remember not just your voice, but also every time you advance a slide. So the timing will match what you're doing. The way to do that is in the right sidebar, go to Document and then Audio. And then you'll see a Record button here. Hit Record and it will go into presentation mode, just like you're presenting. So depending upon how many screens you have with your Mac, you're going to see something a little different. You can always customize here with that button there to customize what's on the different screens. But here on this screen, I see my current slide and the next slide. It's similar to what you might see, say, on your MacBook screen if you're presenting, where on the projector you've got just the current slide. Notice at the bottom here I've got a little volume meter here. I've got some playback controls including a record control. So when I hit record it's going to count down and then it's going to allow me to talk through the presentation and advance the slides and it's going to record all of that. So let's do one of those recordings. Here are 10 interesting facts about Apple. So the price of the first Apple computer was $666.66. Now I clicked the record button again at the end of the last slide when I'm done recording and it stops. And you can see now I've got a timeline here and I could slide back and forth and it even shows me what slide I'm on. And if any time during this I want, I could press play and I could hear my voice. So I can review what's going on. Now if I get to a point where say I've screwed up a little bit here, I could start the recording from that point. So I can hit record here. It'll replace from this point on in the recording. So as you're recording, if you mess up, immediately stop. Then you can move the playback head back a little bit, find the right spot, and start recording again from there. So you don't have to do the entire thing perfectly all the way through. So when you get all the way to the end and your recording is just like you want it, or close enough, hit the X button there at the top and now you'll return to the regular presentation, except that if you look under Document Audio you'll see a recording here and a clear button. You can clear it to clear it out and start again. Record takes you back into the recording interface and now I can move the timeline around and re-record. Once I have this recorded I'm ready to export with those timings in place. First let's add music though. You can drag and drop any music you want into the soundtrack here. I actually have a MP3 file here and I could put it in there. So you could see it appear. Now be warned that music at regular volume is going to overpower your voice. So you're going to want to bring the volume way down low, like down to here. And now we can try exporting. So we'll go to File, Export to, Movie, choose a resolution here, and choose Slideshow Recording. It should already be chosen. And then we hit Next. And it's going to export and now you end up with a video like this. I'll open it up here in QuickTime Player and hit play to hear what it sounds like, and I want to check the music volume compared to my voice. I also want to check the total time. So notice here I see that it's 3 minutes and 57 seconds, which is longer than the music I have. So I'm going to want to get a piece of music that matches that time and use that instead. But notice that too, in soundtrack you can change from play once to loop. So you can just keep looping this piece of music if that works for you. Of course, your slideshow can include a lot more in terms of graphics. You could include images and clip art. You can also do transitions between the slides and animations as each slide builds in and out. And once you have a finished video, you can actually bring that into iMovie and combine it with other things that you have. Like for instance, live video of you introducing the content or wrapping it up at the end. I'll upload the result of this example so you could see it if you like. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.